Hi, it's Viv from Plugin Republic. In this video, we're going to be looking at dynamic pricing in WooCommerce. Dynamic pricing is a way of offering discounts or extra fees to your customers based on certain parameters. A really common example is bulk discount. So for example, buy 10 or more of a product and get a 10% discount. We'll look at bulk pricing and other examples of dynamic pricing, including buy one, get one free. If your customer buys one of a certain item, they'll get the second one for free. There are lots of variations on this, like buy one, get one half price, or buy two of product X, get one of product Y, and so on. Discounts based on the order total. This is a bit like bulk discounts, but instead of being based on the quantity of a product, you can define discounts based on the total value of the user's cart. So if a customer spends more than $500, you give them a 10% discount. There are plenty of reasons to use dynamic pricing on your site. It's a great way to sell more products because you're encouraging your customers to buy more items in order to achieve the discount. This, in turn, is helpful if you want to clear out all stock. Discounts are also a great way to promote your products to new customers and to increase the average order value. So to create discounts in WooCommerce, you'll need the WooCommerce Fees and Discounts plugin. This allows you to create all kinds of dynamic pricing incentives, including bulk discounts and role-based prices. Let's look at some examples of what you can do with fees and discounts. In this product, we want to create some bulk discounts so that if you buy more than 10 items, you get a 10% discount. If you buy more than 20, you get a 20% discount. And if you buy more than 30, you get a 30% discount. To do that, we first ensure that Fees and Discounts is installed and activated. Then we go to its settings page. Click on Dynamic Pricing and create a new pricing rule. We'll choose Bulk Discount in the Offer Type field, then we'll choose which products will qualify for the discount. You can specify all products, or certain categories, or certain products. In this case, we'll just apply the discount to one product. We can enter that product in the Buy Products field. You can enter as many products as you like in here. You can also create as many rules as you like, so you can create different discounts for different products, categories, and user roles. Note that you could limit this offer to certain user roles if you wanted. That's useful if you're running a wholesale or member site, for example, so you can create special discounts for certain customer groups. Then we create our discount tiers. We'll enter a minimum quantity of 10 in the first tier with a maximum quantity of 20, then choose our adjustment type. This could be a discount or an extra fee, and it can be calculated as a percentage or a fixed amount. We'll choose percentage discount for now. Then we'll specify how much the discount is worth for this quantity. If you like, you can add a label that will help the user understand the discount they're receiving. You can repeat these steps for as many tiers as you want. On the last tier, you can leave the maximum quantity field empty. This means that there's no upper limit to the number of items that qualify for the discount. One last thing, we can display a table that displays the bulk discounts on the product page. You can select where to display this here. Save the changes and let's take a look on the front end. You can see that here's our discount table, showing the customer exactly how much the item costs, depending on the quantity. If we select a quantity, you'll see that the price updates dynamically. Then, when we add the product to the cart, the discount is clearly displayed. So that's how to create a bulk discount in WooCommerce. Now let's take a look at creating discounts based on the total order value. Let's go back to the settings page. We'll set the offer type field to order total. We've got a different set of tiers now, where we need to enter the minimum and maximum order total instead of quantity. So let's create some tiers to provide the user with a discount when they order a certain value. Hit save, and let's go back to the front end and add some products to the cart. You can see that when we go past the minimum amount in the first tier, the discount is applied. Finally, let's look at how to create a buy one, get one free offer. We'll choose buy X, get X in the order type setting. This just means that the purchased product and the discounted product are the same. If you'd like to offer a free gift, for example, instead, you could choose buy X, get Y. This would mean that the discounted product was different from the purchased product. Again, you can choose whether to apply this offer to all products, or to products within certain categories, or to specific products. We'll just apply it to one product for now. Enter the product name in the Buy Products field. The Buy setting allows you to specify how many of each item you need to purchase to qualify for the discount. And the Get setting allows you to specify how many items will be discounted. So in this case, we want to buy one and get one free. So we enter 1 in Buy and 1 in Get. If you wanted to create a Buy 2, Get 1 free offer instead, you'd enter 2 in Buy and 1 in Get. You can place a limit on how many discounted items the user can receive by entering a value in Max Items. Then you can set the adjustment type. So in our case, we're going to discount the product by 100%. Click Save, then take a look on the front end. We'll add the product to our cart. We've only added one, so you can see it's at full price. But if we then add a second item, you can see that it's discounted to give us it for free. So there you go. Three examples of creating dynamic pricing rules in WooCommerce. You'll need the WooCommerce Fees and Discounts plugin available from pluginrepublic.com. For more information, check out the resources section on the website, where you'll find dozens of tutorials and case studies. Thanks for watching, and make sure you hit the like and subscribe buttons.